Seizures are one of the most common reasons we see pets in veterinary neurology. A seizure is an unusually strong burst of uncontrolled electrical activity in the brain. However, seizures themselves are not a disease, but rather a symptom of a disease. There are two types of seizures, focal seizures and generalized seizures. Focal seizures are limited to one region of the brain. Your pet is conscious and may only experience activity in a single body part, such as tremoring of the lip or the eye, or even hypersalivation. Generalized seizures, on the other hand, affect the entire brain. In a classic episode, your pet will lose consciousness, collapse, and the whole body will convulse. Sometimes they may also have involuntary defecation and urination. Most seizures last less than a minute, but your pet may appear wobbly, disoriented, or even blind for a short time afterwards. Prior to a seizure, your pet may exhibit abnormal behavior, such as anxiety or clinginess. Seizures are classified into three different categories: reactive, symptomatic, and idiopathic. Reactive seizures result from a problem outside of the brain that is secondarily affecting the brain. These causes include metabolic disturbances such as low blood sugar, kidney or liver disease, electrolyte abnormalities such as low calcium, and exposure to toxins. Symptomatic seizures result from a problem inside of the brain. These causes include structural abnormalities such as inflammation, brain tumors, strokes, congenital malformations, infections, and head trauma. Idiopathic seizures have no identifiable cause. Idiopathic epilepsy is a condition characterized by recurrent generalized seizures with no identifiable cause. This is most likely genetic and the most common reason for seizures in dogs. However, this is not the case for cats. Most diseases outside of the brain are diagnosed from diagnostic tests, such as blood work, urine testing, bile acids, chest and/or abdominal x-rays. When no obvious cause is found outside of the brain, a MRI is typically recommended. Most diseases inside of the brain are diagnosed with an MRI. Pending the MRI results, a cerebrospinal fluid analysis may be performed after the MRI to provide more information. Idiopathic epilepsy can be characterized by a normal neurological exam, normal behavior between seizures, and onset between 6 months to 6 years of age. However, the only way to definitively diagnose idiopathic epilepsy is to rule out all other causes. Appropriate treatment of seizures depends on accurately diagnosing the underlying cause. If a cause is discovered, it is imperative to address it concurrently. However, regardless of the cause, we don't expect to stop all seizures completely for most pets. Anti-seizure medications are used to decrease the frequency, severity, and duration. Because seizures are a symptom of a disease, prognosis depends on the underlying cause of your pet's seizures. Assuming the prognosis of the cause is not poor, epileptic pets can live long, happy lives with a commitment from you. You do not need to let your vet know every time your dog has a seizure, but the following situations are emergencies that warrant calling your vet, a neurologist, or an emergency clinic immediately. The first time your pet has a seizure lasting longer than 3 minutes, more than one seizure in a 24-hour period, or your pet begins having seizures more often than usual. If you're searching for answers to your pet's seizures, call Southeast Veterinary Neurology today. Our team of board-certified veterinary neurologists have the knowledge, experience, and the cutting-edge technology to expertly diagnose and treat seizures in your pet.